will see. When you the dead will rise. When you all hearts will praise. When you the darkness flee. When you my heart screams I hate.
I am free.
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 He's never going to leave us nor forsake us. Doesn't matter what we've done. He will always be there for us. All we got to do is repent, reset, and revive ourselves in Him.
Amen.
Thank you.
This song is a song from Peter Coulter, which means my soul longs for you. So I'm just going to ask you, if you really feel in your heart you want to be touched by Jesus, just double click to the right. Just focus on your own personal relationship with God. Hallelujah. God, we come to seek your face tonight. If that's your cry, just lift up your hand. Come on, church. God, we come to meet you tonight. Our soul cries out to you. Our flesh cries out to you. Father God, we want to know you. We want to carry you in a different and deeper way, Father God. Just lift up your voices in your own words. Begin to lift up your hunger. Begin to lift up your voices in your own words. Just ask the Lord tonight. Holy Spirit, fill me, Father God. Fill your people, Jesus, as we spread the gospel of the good news about Christ, Father. May your light shine. May your power penetrate the people, Father God. God, let us be known as a generation who seeks your face. Let us be known as a generation that calls after your name. Father, we believe you. Your word is alive and well. Your word speaks truth, Father God. I pray, Lord Jesus, that you would just touch the lives of your people, Father God. Hallelujah. Listen to the words too. It's very easy. I know you can do it. Hallelujah. Listen to the words. Come see with me.
Yeah. tonight. I want to thank God for giving us an opportunity to be together in our college and career concert series. You all may be seated. I'm so thankful. This is a vision. You know, we've been in Garden Grove for many, many years, and I want to thank God because He's given our pastors a vision for families, a vision for college and career, a vision for those people that are in between sort of their lives, trying to figure out who am I going to marry, where am I going to go to school, where am I going to live, how am I going to get a job, all these things. And one of the reasons why we felt inclined to do college and career was because people at crossroads in their lives. And I want to thank God because in addition to college and career, we have a very strong youth ministry. And I want to thank God because in 2015 already, it hasn't even been a full quarter yet, and God continues to change people's lives. And I'm here as a living testimony of God's grace and God's mercy. And I'm going to have Josue, one of the kids in our call, in our youth group, to give his testimony. The Lord changed him. You know, what I think is pretty amazing from that what I think is pretty cool is in college and career, you know, we're kind of at a point where, you know, especially we're not, this is not regular church, right? This is a concert. So I basically told, you know, the praise and worship team and including myself, like, hey, we can wear whatever we want because we're college and career. And then I talked to Josue maybe 2 or 3 months ago and said, dude, I want you to give a testimony during our concert. And he's like, yeah, absolutely. And I just met with him a couple weeks ago, make sure he was on track. We met last week. We had a great time in the Lord together, right? And then he shows up today in a suit. I thought he'd come in like jeans and stuff. So I want to thank God because to me, that's a living testimony of God's grace and mercy. And that's respect. Let's give respect and honor where honor's due. And I want to thank God because he felt inclined to be respectful of the Lord. And so he showed up in a suit. And I'm just thankful for that too. Because I think that shows that God's continued to change his life too. So just do the best we can to support him, gang.
Who's got a good enough thoughts on it? For those who don't know me, my name is Josue Ontiveros. I've been coming to church for like about 6 years. I'm 15 now. And before I was saved, I was living a very simple life. I used to go to parties. I used to do a bunch of stuff I wasn't supposed to. But thankfully, I found God, and I'm glad for that. When I was doing this, like all the sin I was doing, my grandma was in the hospital. She got cancer. She got stage 3 cancer. And I was really hurt. And then when I was doing this, I thought to myself, why should I be doing this? Like, it's my grandma. And I also thought, like, why is God doing this to my grandma? Like, what did she do to deserve this? But as I was thinking, there is also someone else, someone bad, and it's Satan. And, like, I'm pretty sure he was the one that did this to my grandma, but God has power.
Yes,
and God. And God saved her, God healed her, and He's beginning to heal her, and He's also healing me. And thanks to Eric Cordero, he's right there, he helped me. God, I know that He died on the cross, rose again the third day, and is now the right hand of God. Amen.
Amen.
God bless him. I want to thank God again because God's alive and well. And you know, we choose to turn toward Christ. Everyone has that opportunity to turn toward Christ. And the good news is that God's salvation is available to everyone, and I want to thank God for that. So we're going to move on to the word tonight, which is the most important part. And I want to thank God because in praise and worship, we enter to the gates and then we get into the inner sanctuary. And once we're in the inner sanctuary now, that's an area that we can ask the Lord for what we need. But it's so important that now that we're in the presence of God, that He shares His word with us, that we can be empowered by what He has to share. And I want to thank God for Eric, who's actually going to give the word tonight. And, you know, I've known Eric for many, many years, and he grew up here in the church. And I want to thank God. He's a great partner in college and career. And I want to thank God for the things that he's doing in Eric's life as well. So I'm going to ask Eric to come up, and then feel free to give the word.
Praise God. I'm just excited to be in the house of the Lord tonight.
Amen.
A couple things. That kid that just spoke to me, he has a soft spot in my heart, man. He has a really soft spot in my heart, man. You know, it wasn't me that changed him. You know, it wasn't me. I was just an instrument that God used. You know, the Lord put in my heart a while back ago. He felt like, you know what? Friday nights, do an open session with the youth. Help them out. Talk to them about God. And just do it. And I felt it for a long time. Never did it. Until recently, you know, a couple months ago. I'm going to tell you guys the honest truth. That kid right there, that's the last kid I thought that was going to be changed. Oh, he was I thought he had the hardest heart. He was, you know, I was like, oh my God, it's going to be hard with him. But he was the first one to change. Yeah. He was the first one to be transformed. Amen. Nothing is impossible for God. Nothing is impossible for God, amen. I was just so excited to be here tonight. Amen. I remember the last concert that we had, I wasn't lying when we said that it's going to get bigger and bigger. It's not the amount of people we had the last time. We had more people. And I know it's going to keep on growing. The next concert, we're going to have all the seats full. And it's just such a great excitement. It's a great excitement for me to be here tonight. And I hope it is for you guys too. Because I know the Lord has something for each and every one of you guys tonight. It's not here that you're here by coincidence. I guarantee you, you're not here by coincidence. You're here because the Lord wants to have a divine appointment with you. You know, every minute, 107 people die. Every minute. But God chose you to be here tonight and not dead. He chose you to be alive and not dead. Out of those 107 people every minute, you're here. Because the Lord wants to do something in your life tonight. The Lord wants to change you. The Lord wants to transform you tonight. Amen. Think about that. Just say, Lord, what do you have for me tonight? I know you want to change me. I know you want to transform me. What is it? Show me. Show me what it is. You know, before we get started, I'm going to ask my lovely pastor that gave me the opportunity to do this and that has given me the opportunity, and Sister Julie, you know, that, you know, allow me. Hey, you know what? Yeah, you go preach. I just want to thank them from the bottom of my heart. Thank you so much for the second opportunity I get to preach in this concert series. And before I get started, let's just pray. I'm going to ask you to lead us into prayer.
Amen. I'm going to ask everyone to please stand. Why don't we have those with the phone in the pit? Amen. The Spirit of God is moving today. Amen. El Espíritu de Dios estamos viendo en nuestras vidas, gloria al Señor. Disculpe que no tenemos alguien que va a interpretar, pero el Espíritu de Dios que está en usted y que está en nosotros, que está en Eric, amen, está conectado.
Yes.
Amen. Está conectando. We're not going to translate this in Spanish, but I just like the people that know that speak Spanish, that God's going to connect with them. And the spirit that's in Eric is going to translate to them, and the spirit of God that's in them is going to be connected. Amen? So vamos a orar, let's all pray and ask the Lord to bless the word today, because, you know, God's word is already blessed.
Yes.
Because it's from Him, but we need to ask prayer over Eric. Amen. Yes. Heavenly Father, we come to you in the name of Jesus, asking you to bless us and to help us. Father God, right now, Lord, I ask that you open up our hearts and our mind to receive the word that you have for each and every one of us right now. Father God, we have visitors here that have not heard the word. We ask that you open up their hearts and their mind to penetrate through, Father God. And we ask that you use Eric in a mighty special way, Lord. We ask that you penetrate through his words, Father God, that as he speaks, Father God, that he'll be obedient to you and say the words that you have taught him and that you have shown him of what to say, God.
Yes, Lord,
we ask that you use him in a mighty special way,
Jesus.
God, because he is ready and willing and able to do what you have called him out to do, Lord. And I ask once again, Father God, for the people right now, as we open up our hearts and our mind to receive
Lord.
You. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Yeah, you see you tonight. I'm going to be speaking about a story that we all know. Amen. This is a story about King David. We all know King David. Amen. We know what he did, we know who he was, and we know how God used him, and we know what he fell into. Amen. And I'm not going to read the whole thing, I'm not going to go through it, but there's more to that. Amen. He was anointed before he hit that man. He was anointed. Amen. And we see, a man after God's own heart. Amen. That's something very special. That's something very special. But you guys have that same blessing. Because the fact that you're here in this world is because God chose you from the heavenly realm to come down. God said, I'm going to bring my child down to the earth. I'll bring my son down to this earth. You're not here in vain. You're here for a purpose. And you're as special as King David was. Because God chose you from the heavenly realm to this earth. And now it's your time to fulfill what you have to do in this world. It's your time. It's your turn, and it's your time to stand up, to rise, to move forward, and start conquering the world. We don't want it to be the enemies anymore. It no longer can be the enemies. We have to take charge. We have to move forward, and we have to conquer the world. Amen. And we've been praying actually at this church. We're going to conquer Garden Grove.
Yes.
Amen. We're going to conquer Garden Grove. I don't know if that excites you, but I don't know about you guys, but we're going to conquer Garden Grove. Amen. We see 1 Samuel 16:7 says like this. Amen. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. But the Lord said to Samuel, do not look at his appearance or at his physical stature, because I have refused him. For the Lord does not see as man sees. For man looks at the outward appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart. The Lord looks at the heart. Not the outward appearance, you know, even though I look pretty good tonight, right? Thank you. But anyways, God looks at the heart. You know, a lot of people feel ashamed. A lot of people feel, you know, pressed in their heart that they can't come to church because, oh, I just sinned last night, or I just sinned before I came to church. Oh, I feel guilty. I can't do this anymore. No, God looks at your heart. He doesn't look at your outward appearance. He doesn't look at what you're doing. Or he doesn't look at what you're going to do. Because God already knows what you're going to do before you do it. Amen? And then we jump all the way down to, we're going to start talking about the story of David and Goliath. Amen? So we're going to jump all the way down to chapter 17, verse 32, where it says like this. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Then David said to Saul, let no man's heart fail because of him. Your servant will go and fight with the Philistine. Amen. When we fall in love with God, or it's our first love, as it says in the Bible, we become brave Christians. Oh, nothing's going to do me any harm. I'm a Christian. Nothing's going to stop me.
Yes.
I'm going to keep on going forward. I don't care what the world tells me. I'm going to go forward. You become brave. But then what happens? Many of us grew up in the church. Many of us as little kids, our parents would bring us, and we would be here every Monday, Tuesday, every Thursday, and Sunday nights as well. We'd be here all the time. And then something happens in our lives, it's called free will, that we choose to separate from God. Amen? And we see the story of King David in verses 17, 34 to 37. It just talks about how everybody was scared of this giant. Everybody was scared of this giant. Amen? And when he went up there, he's all like, hey, I fought lions before. I fought bears before. What's this man going to do to me? And not only that, I got God on my side. Amen? That's all he needed. That is all that he needed. God, his power, and his authority to go defeat that giant. Amen? And many of us, we have giants in our lives. It could be our husband. It could be our job. It could be our debt. Whatever it is, our depression, lack of love, those are all giants in our lives that we're allowing to conquer us. That we're being afraid and we're not being like David. You know what? I fought other stuff before. I could take this on. Amen? It said, he told Goliath, you come with me with sword, I come with you with Jesus.
Yes.
You come with me with sword, I come with you with Jesus.
Amen.
It says 2 Corinthians 10:4, the weapons we fight with are not the weapons of the world. In the contrary, they have divine power to demolish strongholds.
Yes.
Amen. They have power to demolish. It doesn't say to kill or to just, beat down. It says to demolish. When something's demolished, it's thrown on the ground, it's stepped on, and it's out of here. Amen. And that's what you need to know in your life. That the Bible and the love of God is what's going to conquer your fear. The power and the love of God is what's going to conquer your depression. What's going to conquer your lack of love. What's going to conquer your debt. But don't get me wrong, yeah, you still have to do those payments. But don't underestimate God.
Yes, Lord.
He can have someone pay that debt off for you.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. You have the power to demolish those strongholds. You have the power to take down those giants. You have that power. God has given you that power. Chapter 1, verse 18 to 20 says like this. Come now and let us reason together. Let us talk. You know, let me counsel you. That counsel that you've been seeking, that's the wrong one. Come to me. Let me talk to you. I'll counsel you. I'll give you the truth. Amen. Come now, let us reason together, says the Lord. Though your sins are like scarlet, they shall be white as snow. Someone say amen to that.
Amen.
That's good news. That's good news right there. Amen. That's good news. Your sins are like scarlet, they will turn like as white as snow. I'm telling you, God is just God. Amen. God doesn't look at your outward appearance, He looks at your heart. If you want to change, He's going to change your sin. You're going to be a person that's just blossoming. Amen. Like a beautiful flower. It's just going to blossom in the Lord's garden. And you're just going to be the most precious being out there.
Amen.
But you just have to reason with God. You have to speak to Him. You have to ask Him. Come to me, says the Lord. Come to me. Amen. And then we go on and says, they shall be as white as snow. Though they are like crimson, they shall be like wool. If you're willing and obedient. Amen. Like I said, your will. It's your will. It's your will that's going to bring you. Amen. It says like, even if there's like crimson. Even though it's like crimson, it shall become like wool. Amen. If you guys don't know this already, wool, that material is expensive. Wool, the people that know wool is expensive. Just natural wool. You know why it's expensive? Because of the process it takes to get it. The labor it takes to get wool is hard. And that's why wool is expensive. I want you guys to know that tonight, the Lord wants to change you. Salvation is expensive. But Jesus died for me and for you so it can be free. Just like wool is expensive, the labor is hard. To get wool, the labor it takes. But you know what? That's how salvation is. Like wool. It was a hard labor. But you know what? Jesus did that labor already. And it's free to you. It's free to you. Open up your mind. It's completely free to you. It's free to you. Amen. And it says like this. If you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. But if you refuse and rebel, you shall be devoured by the sword, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. There's blessing. There's blessing when you receive God. Yeah, life might be hard, but there's a blessing. We have free will. We can choose either to be here or to be out there in the world doing things we're not supposed to be doing. We could go to a party. Yeah, let's go to a party after this. And okay, yeah. But you don't know what's going to happen to you at that party. If the Lord is speaking to you tonight, change your heart. Give it to the Lord. Give it to the Lord. Amen. Just like that wool that's expensive. Salvation was expensive, but Jesus made it free. Amen. Salvation was expensive, but Jesus made it free. Like I said, he wasn't walking with this cross, and just because he couldn't handle it anymore, he left it, and I'm not going to do anything about it. He carried his cross all the way to the end. All the way to the end, he carried his cross. That was for you. For you. Give your hearts to the Lord. Amen. We see with King David, after the sin he committed with Bathsheba, cheated on his wife. he tried to lie about pregnancy. A lot of sin was committed in that part of his life. But you know what? Out of that came King Solomon. Out of that sin came King Solomon. The first baby died, but King Solomon came. And he was the most wise king. He was the most wise king. King Solomon. Don't let your sin say you can't do anything. Don't let your sin say you can't do anything. All those problems you've gone through, if you change them, maybe someone else is going through those problems right now and you can help them come out of it because you already went through it. That depression you were going through, God changed it around to happiness, and now someone that's depressed, you can go and help them and pray for them. And so, you know what? I went through that same situation, but there is a God. There is Jesus that died on the cross for me, and he died for you too. Let your situations turn into a blessing. Because whatever your problems is, God can turn that into a blessing for someone else. Don't let your problems hold you down. It's time to stand up. Get those giants out of your way. Yeah, they may come to you with swords and everything, but you come to them in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, you come to them. The weapons we fight with are not of the world. That's what it says in the Word. The weapons we fight with are not of this world. In the contrary, they have divine. Do you know what divine is? Divine power. Divine from up above, from God. Divine power to demolish strongholds that are holding you down. Give your hearts to Jesus. Forget about your past. I had to forget about my past. Was it easy? No. Can you do it? Yeah. Now it's time for you to do it. Give your hearts to Jesus. Give your hearts to Jesus. We have the altar open. We have pastors here that can pray for you guys. If there's anybody here, anybody that wants to accept the Lord as your Savior, or if there's anybody that just wants to reconcile with the Lord, Lord, I grew up in the church, I departed, I left, but I want to come back to your feet. I'm tired of living out there in that world. Or you might not know the Lord. And God spoke to you tonight. And he's changing your heart, and you feel that warmth in your heart, you feel that uncomfortableness. Come to the front. It takes that step of obedience. It takes that step of obedience to be changed. Remember, you have free will. You can't deal with those sins anymore. Choose to lead to Jesus. God wants to change you. I want you guys to rest your feet.
You breathe your life into my lungs. You bring to life these dry bones. I know that you're alive. You call me one of your own. I know.